गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास,
आई एम हियर अगेन विद कंटिन्यूइंग द टॉपिक रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड दिस इज गोइंग टू बी द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर दैट इज द पार्ट 7 एंड इन दिस पार्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन एंड इट्स इवेंट्स. नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस about the sexual mode of reproduction, the characteristics of the sexual reproduction, the events during the sexual reproduction and the checkpoints. As you know, I am your educator Hare Krishna Bhagavat and I am going to explain this all. Now, what's the sexual mode of reproduction is? You might have come across with this in the lesson number 1, part 1. So, there is no much more to elaborate over here, but just to remember this topic, I am just going to throw it. Now let's say that it is the mode of reproduction in which two types of parents are required to produce a different kind of individuals. The parents are one is male and another is female. And as you know, the male is who produces sperm and female is who produces female gamete egg. And what the sperm is, the sperm is the motile haploid cell. Motile haploid cell means the cell which is motile, which can move from one place to the another with the help of flagella. And it is haploid means it has only one set of chromosome. And another is the female. Female is who that produces egg. And egg is also a haploid cell, but here the cell is non-motile without any locomotory organelle and it is almost sedentary. And this mode of reproduction, that is the sexual mode of reproduction, is mostly seen among the multicellular and most complex and higher group of animals that belongs to the kingdom Plantae and Animalia, and it is also present in the human being as well. Now let's discuss about the about its characteristic of the sexual reproduction. You might remember those topic that I had discussed in detail about these. So let's remembering those topic right now. It is a biparental mode of reproduction. That means two type of parents are required. One is male, another is female. The progenies are not similar to their parents as well as among themselves. There is a variation takes place so that it contributes to the evolution. It is very important that there is a variation. The parents and progenies are never similar to them, and not even they are similar among themselves, and thus they contribute to the evolution, because we know that evolution is the process in which organism are always evolve to each other, always shows differences to each other for the survival of the race. The gamete, here what happens here, the gamete formation takes place. As you know, here the male gamete is a sperm and the female gamete is ovum, and their formation takes place over here. That process is called gametogenesis. And here the fertilization or the union of male and female gamete takes place. Here, due to this process, because these processes are very lengthy and it takes time, they cannot be done at a very short period of time. That's why here multiplication is very slow and it always takes place in unfavorable condition. Why it takes place in unfavorable condition? Because you know that the nature is an ever-changing process, and within the changed environment, every organism has to change, and for this change environment, variants are always get produced by the sexual reproduction. Now, let's discuss about the events during sexual reproduction. Here, all those events that takes place during the sexual reproduction can be categorized into three main categories. They are pre-fertilization events, fertilization event, and post-fertilization event. If someone asks that what is the most important event that takes place in the sexual reproduction, is the most important is the fertilization. So fertilization is the union of male and female gamete. Now let's start with the pre-fertilization event. Pre-fertilization means it involves all those events that takes place prior to the fertilization. It mainly involves three main steps. The number one is the organogenesis of the gonads, means the development of the sex organs in which the germ cells has to form, then the gametogenesis. Gametogenesis is the process of formation of germ cells, and then the gamete transfer means the transfer of the gametes from one organism to the another. Now let's discuss them separately. Now let's hear what I had did in this part. It is very, very important for you all and to the students or also those who are seeking for the medical examination. Here I am comparing those events side by side between the plants and animal, because in the next chapter, in chapter number 2, you will have to study about the sexual reproduction in plants, and thereby in the chapter number 3 you will have to study about the sexual reproduction in animal, especially in those of the humans. So here in case of plants, it involves the origin and development of the reproductive organs. Like flower, we know that the flowers are the modified suit meant for sexual reproduction, and it mainly composed of 4 main organs that completes a flower. They are sepal, petal, stamen and carpel, as you know. And you know that this organogenesis takes place within the plant. We know that the flower is a modified suit. And here, out of the sepal and petal, we know that sepal and petal are the accessory sex organ, and stamen and carpel are the principal sex organs. The stamen is the male sex organ, and the carpel is the female sex organ. Likewise, let's come to the topic. As in case of animals, it involves the origin and development of the gonads. Gonads are the site where the origin, development and differentiation of germ cells, gamete formation takes place over there. In male, the gametes, the gonads are testes, where the development of the sperm takes place. Sorry for that time. And in the female, it is the ovary where the formation of egg or the ovum takes place. Now let's see. Let's gametogenesis. Gametogenesis means the formation of the gamete. I am just defining over here it and not elaborating the topic in detail, because we have to study that. I had told you that we have to study in everything about the reproduction in plants in chapter number 2 and about animals in chapter number 3, and I will discuss each and everything in very elaborated manner and very systematic way to make it understand to you about these. Now let's come to the topic, gametogenesis. Gametogenesis is the process of formation of gametes or the germ cells. We know that the 2 types of the gametes are there, but in case of plant, the gametes are differently said. For example, as in case of plants, the microsporogenesis or the formation of male gamete or the pollen grain. Here the pollen grain or the male gamete is called microspore or the pollen grain, and their formation is called microsporogenesis, that takes place inside the stamen, which is the male sex organ. And here the female sex cell or the gamete is called female gamete or the egg, that takes place, and their process of formation is called megasporogenesis, that takes place within the carpel, which is the female sex organ. Now in case of animals, it is called spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis or the formation of male gamete or the sperm, which takes place inside the testes. And the oogenesis or the formation of female gamete or egg or ovum, that takes place inside the ovary. Am I clear with this? So as I hope so that you are getting it very sharply. Now let's see, that is the gamete transfer. Gamete transfer means the transfer of the male gamete from the male sex organ to the female sex organ. It is also very important, that takes place inside the animal and plant separately. In case of plant, this process is called pollination. Pollination means the transfer of pollen grain from stamen to stigma, as you know, and this is get carried out with the help of both abiotic and biotic factor. For example, as in case of pollination that takes place by insect, this is called entomology, and we will discuss about this in detail in chapter number 2 as well. Now let's go for the animals. Here in case of animal, except the mammal, in case of all mammals or all the animals except the humans, the process of transfer of gamete from the male organ to the female organ is called insemination. But in case of human, it is called coitus or sex. As you know, during the sex or coitus, the male organ sends the sperm within the female body, where the sperm starts to travel for the fertilization of the egg. Now, the next is the fertilization. Fertilization is the most important, as I had told you, that is, it is the most important and crucial step that takes place inside the reproductive process of female, reproductive process, sexual reproduction. And here what happened, it is the union of male and female gamete, and it is of two main types depending upon where it takes place. If it is takes place outside the female body, it is called external fertilization, that is outside the body, that is external, in the external environment, for example, as in case of fishes and amphibia, that takes place inside the water. And then the internal fertilization inside the female body, as in case of human, as in oviduct or fallopian tubule. And various things are there to discuss in this also. So we will discuss about this in chapter number 3 as well. And now the fertilization involves 5 main steps. One is the meeting of male and female gamete, the fertilizing and anti-fertilizing reaction. It is very important. So don't miss my those classes in which I will discuss about fertilizing and anti-fertilizing reaction, because let me cite an example that we know that the female always produces in a one menstrual cycle, the female produces one egg and the male produces millions of sperm, but all the times the million of sperm, the only one is capable to fertilize the egg and rest are died. The question arises, why it happens so? So this is only because of the fertilizing and anti-fertilizing reaction, and we will discuss about it in detail in the forthcoming chapters. Now, next is the barrier penetration, then the activation of ovum, and that the empimixis. Empimixis is the union of male and female pronucleus within the egg. Now, next is the post-fertilization events, that what happens just after the fertilization. I had also differentiated these two processes in both the plants and animal as well. In case of plant, it is embryogenesis, that is the formation of embryo, then the endosperm formation. Endosperm is the nutritious part that is present inside the seed that provides nutrition during the germination of the plant, and then the seed formation, then the fruit formation. This is all about that takes place within the sexual reproduction in plants. And in case of animals, they involve the embryogenesis, the implantation, the pregnancy, the gestation, the partition. Partition is the process of childbirth that takes place after the completion of gestation, and then the lactation. Lactation is the feeding of child through the mammary gland. This is all about the reproduction that takes place inside this. As I hope so that you may have came across with all my lessons of this first chapter number 1. And I had made 1 to 7 part. I had divided this whole chapter into 7 parts. And I had tried my level best to make each and every topic very lucid and very understanding and very easy. Now, let's come to the point, that is the checkpoints. Why meiosis is essential during gametogenesis? It is very important question, very important question. So you must try to answer this and make a comparative account on a spermatogenesis, oogenesis, microsporogenesis and megasporogenesis. So this will brought you up to an standard that you can differentiate the processes and what are the similarity between these 4 processes and what are the major differences between them. And next, last question is very important also, that is explain the role of sexual reproduction in the evolution. It is also very crucial question that why sexual reproduction contributes to evolution. So try to answer these questions and answer. When you had answered those, then produce it in my mailbox so that I can check it out. Now, till then, thank you for listening carefully. Thank you for tonight. And I will meet tomorrow with the next topic. I will start the chapter number 2, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. So be there and always be keeping listening to me and making topic understanding. Thank you. Thank you again.